Next question. Show that the right circular cylinder of given surface and maximum volume is such that its height is equal to the diameter of the base. So it's a right circular cylinder. Given surface means its surface area is a constant and volume is maximum. Then we have to show that its height is equal to the diameter. Okay. So what we will do first is we will take the radius of the cylinder as x, height of the cylinder as y. Okay, S be the surface area and V be the volume as usual. What's the formula to find surface area of a cylinder? That is 2 pi RH plus 2 pi R square, isn't it? So here as radius and height are X and Y, what we will get is 2 pi XY plus 2 pi X square. From here, since we are differentiating with respect to X, from here calculate the value of y. So what we get, 2 pi xy is equal to s minus 2 pi x square. So that y is equal to s minus 2 pi x square divided by 2 pi x. Let it be here. Okay, s is a constant because it is given that surface area is constant. 2 is constant, pi is constant. So the only variable here is x. Okay, again what we have to show, we have to show that when max volume is maximum, height is equal to the diameter. So we will maximize the volume. Volume of the cylinder. What's the volume of the cylinder? Pi r square h. So here it will be pi x square y. So that is equal to pi into x square into, instead of y, we can write this value, s minus 2 pi x square divided by 2 pi x. So pi gets cancelled. X square 1 x get cancelled, giving you x into s minus 2 pi x square divided by 2. So if I open the bracket by multiplying with s, what I get is sx minus 2 pi x cube divided by 2. Okay, so what we have to do next, we have to differentiate v with respect to x. So dv by dx equal to 1 by 2 is a constant. Derivative of sx is s minus derivative of 2 pi x cube is 2 pi into 3x square. That is equal to 1 by 2 into s minus 6 pi x square. The next step is equate dv by dx to 0, which implies half into s minus 6 pi x square is equal to 0, which implies 6 pi x square is equal to s, and s is equal to, x is equal to s by 6 pi. X square is s by 6 pi, so x will be equal to root of s by 6 pi. Okay. Again, what we have to do, we have to apply second derivative test. So, we have to differentiate this dv by dx again. So, d square v by dx square is equal to, half is again a constant. There are two terms. S is a constant. Its derivative will be 0 minus 6 pi x square, out of which 6 is a constant, pi is a constant. Derivative of x square is 2x. Again, what we have to do, we have to find d square v by dx square at x is equal to this value to check whether it is negative or positive. S is equal, x is equal to root of s by 6 pi. That will be half into minus 6 pi. 0 minus this term will be equal to this term itself. 6 pi into 2 into root of s by 6 pi. Will it be negative? 2 get cancelled. Okay. Will it be negative or positive? This is actually the value of x. X we took as a radius. Radius cannot be a negative value. So obviously this is a positive value. So this is positive. Pi is positive. 6 is positive. And a negative is there. So the total sign of this term will be, the sign term is 6 minus 6 pi under root of s by 6 pi. Okay, it will be negative. It will be less than 0. If you want, you can simplify. We just need the sign. That's the reason I am not simplifying. So, it's negative, less than 0, which implies V is maximum at x is equal to root of s by 6 pi. Okay, x equal to root of s by 6 pi is a local maxima, and V is maximum at x is equal to root of s by 6 pi. What we have to prove? We have to prove that height is equal to the diameter. What was height? Y. Y, we have a value. Y is equal to s minus 2 pi x square by 2 pi x. So we will find the value of y. y is equal to s minus 2 pi x square divided by 2 pi x. So that is equal to s minus 2 pi into x square. What is x square? X is root of s by 6 pi. So x square will be s by 6 pi, isn't it? So s by 6 pi divided by 2 pi into root of s by 6 pi. So here pi and pi gets cancelled, 2 and 6 get cancelled, giving you 3. So 3s minus s, 2s. 2s by 3 will be the numerator and denominator is 2 pi into root of s by 6 pi. That's equal to 2 gets cancelled. So what we get is s by 3 pi into root of 6 pi by root of s. Isn't it? So here root of s gets cancelled, giving you root s. Root pi and pi gets cancelled, giving you root pi. So what we get is root s divided by root pi, and here root 6 can be written as root 3 into root 2 divided by, here 3 can be written as root 3 into root 3. Again will get cancelled, isn't it? So what we get is root s by root 3 pi. So will be equal to root of 2s by 3 pi. Okay, this is y. And what we have to show? Height is equal to the diameter of the base. X was the radius. We have to show that height y is equal to 2x. And what is the value of y? Y is root of 2s by 3 pi. We will take 2x. 2x is the diameter. Diameter is 2x. So that is 2 into root of s by 6 pi. If I want to take 2 to the square root, how much I should write inside the square root? It will be 4. Why? Because this 4 when taken outside the square root becomes 2. So 4s by 6 pi, isn't it? Cancelling this will become 2, this will become 3. That is 2s by 3 pi, which is equal to y. So what we are getting? 2 into radius, that means diameter, is equal to the height of the cylinder. Okay.